YouTube. Just got home from work and today I'm doing a video about my Marshall DSL-5C combo for you. I pre-recorded some clips to give you some sound samples where I double-tracked guitars and put a drum set behind it. So listen to that if you want to know what it sounds like, kind of a production. I'm not an engineer, just so you have a listen. And what about this amp? It's a very small 10-inch 5-watt tube amp that I bought like 2 years ago. And it is basically the amp that got me back into guitar playing. I started playing when I was young, with 12 or 13 or something, played for a while, then I stopped. And after my band split and everybody went off to college and stuff like that. And then I wanted to get back into it and bought myself a Fender Frontman 25, which is a transistor amp. I think, again, 10-inch speaker combo thing, but solid state. I never really liked the sound, especially the distortion. So played it in my living room. It was still very, very loud. And never made me want to play more, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. So I put the guitar away and left it there for, I think, another 2 or 3 years. And then I actually stumbled upon Rob Chapman's YouTube channel. And he did a demo with the captain of, I don't know, something. And I thought, man, I'd really like to get back into guitar. And that's when I started researching small valve amps, because I knew I wanted a valve amp and I wanted a Marshall, because then back in the day, Marshall was everything. I was into Guns N' Roses a lot, and of course Slash played Marshall and the Les Paul and all that stuff. So long story short, I did my research online, came across the smallest Marshall there is, which is the 5C, the DSL. And it has everything I wanted. It had a direct line out, which I'm recording right now, so it's not mic'd up. It had a foot switch and two channels. Clean, which is not really Fender clean, but you can hear that. If you dial it up, it really gets crunchy. And a drive channel, overdrive channel, or distortion channel. And a power attenuator, so you could dial it back from 5 to 1 watts, which is still pretty loud. And something called a tone shift and a deep button, which kind of fattens the sound when you use it at lower volume. So I thought this would be perfect for home use, for bedroom slash living room use. And I got that thing. I plucked my Les Paul Studio in it and I loved it from the first minute. This amp really made me want to play a lot more because it got a lot closer to that heavy rock AC/DC saturated Guns N' Roses sound that I loved so much. And I started to plug in my guitar on a daily basis, and I got back into all that gear and pedal kind of stuff like that. I never owned a pedal in my life before, but this amp does not have reverb. So I was into blues playing also, and I wanted a reverb, and I started to do my research on reverb pedals. And the first one I got is, I don't know, I think it's the Big Muff by Electro-Harmonix, which I love. It's a nice reverb, takes up a lot of place. And I got into pedal boards and all that kind of thing. So that's why I thought I'd show that amp to you. And they still make it. It's not so inexpensive. I think it's like $500-$600. But for all you guys who just want to jam out in the living room, want to get back into guitar and don't want to spend too much money, it's a great little amp. I really, really love it. It doesn't do cleans too good because it's a Marshall, but I love the drive channel and the crunchy stuff. So let me give you some simple clean chords. I have the volume from the classic gain. That's what actually the clean channel is called, or the green channel is called, at about, let me see, 6-7 o'clock. So if I turn up the volume of the guitar full, it crunches, but I won't do that. I roll it back a bit. And you can hear distorting already. If I put it down to like a 3, let me do that for you. Let's go to 2 on the volume. So it's never really clean, only at very, very low tone. But when you crank it up and go to like 7, it starts to crunch real nice. And when you push it even more and go into the gain channel, you get this. I have the gain at around about 7 right now, and the volume of the gain at 8. If I put in the tone shift while I play, I try to do it, you can hear what that does. And the deep button. Without the deep. So the deep button basically gives us more low end when you use it at the 1 watt setting. It also does noiseless recording. So if you go into the 5 watts mode and use the direct line out, you won't hear from the speaker. Which is awesome if you want to do silent recording, home recording. Want to do home recording stuff like that. And so it's a really nice amp for stuff like that too. If you're into, like me, Rage Against the Machine, AC/DC, Guns N' Roses, this kind of stuff, even the heavier kind of stuff, put a Tube Screamer in front of it, you can really get it to play some metal. It's a great amp. Go and buy one if you are looking for an amp, which I guess that's why you're watching this video. So yes, one of my favorites. I still use it, even though I got a couple of new ones, but from time to time I bring it back out and I absolutely do love it. You can put it onto a bigger cap. I usually use it through my 2x12 because a 12-inch speaker just moves more air and it sounds better. And I guess that's all I wanted to say about the Marshall DSL-5C. I know that just one last thing before I let you go. I know that they did make a Slash version of this particular amp, if I remember rightly, which I read a lot about and I was thinking about buying it, but it can basically only do slash tone. So it's like a one trick pony. This thing is way more versatile. It's made in China. It's not made in Britain or anything, not for that kind of money. And it doesn't look cheap. It doesn't feel cheap, to be honest. It's a solid little Marshall box. It's heavy. Could you gig with it? I don't think so. It doesn't get loud enough. I mean, if you put a mic, if you mic it, put it through a PA, you could. Or if you use the line out, you could, I guess. Yeah, why not? But it's, I don't even know. I don't think it's for practice, band practice, stuff like that. It's for playing at home if you want a decent sound to play at home. That's what it's made for. So guys, if you are beginners and looking for a good beginner amp, I'd recommend that. I mean, $500, I don't know if that's still a beginner's budget. It wasn't for me, but as I said, I played a while. Man, this video is really getting long. No one's gonna watch that. But anyways, to wrap it up, good little amp, Marshall DSL 5 combo. I don't think that they make a head, only a head of it, because I would have bought that. I would have loved that. And but Marshall's is not into those lunchbox head amps, which I adore because I only play at home. But that's basically all I have to say about that. See you guys next time. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel or at least leave me a thumbs up. And hope you have a good day. See you soon.